If you can sit in the second one there, that'd be great. No, the next one back. Find the Psalms, you want week three. And it'd be good for you just to learn. It's better. When you're reading the Psalm, you can take your mask off.
Doors double open, please. All of them. Maximum draft. I one, Chris two, me three. Let's scripture and responsory. Chris, Magnificat. Me, intentions and close. Okay?
Best if the stewards do the writing, because there's only one person with the pen.
Good evening, you okay? Right, you're on the intercessions at the end. Pauline, yeah. Okay? So let's pray. O God, come to our aid. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Alleluia. Come praise the Lord, the Almighty, the King of all nations. Tell forth his fame, O ye peoples, with loud acclamations. His love is sure, faithful his word shall endure, steadfast through all generations. Praise to the Father most gracious, the Lord of creation. Praise to his Son, the Redeemer, who wrought our salvation. O heavenly Dove, praise to thee, fruit of their love, giver of all consolation.
Our eyes turn to the Lord, we look for his mercy. To you have I lifted up my eyes, you who dwell in the heavens. My eyes like the eyes of slaves on the hand of their lords, like the eyes of a servant on the hand of her mistress. So our eyes are on the Lord our God, till he show us his mercy. Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy. We are filled with contempt. Indeed, all too full is our soul. With the scorn of the rich, with the proud man's disdain. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our eyes are turned to the Lord, we look for his mercy.
Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. The Lord has not been on our side, this is Israel's song. If the Lord had not been on our side when men rose against us, then would they have swallowed us alive when their anger was kindled? Then would the waters have engulfed us, the torrent run over us, over our head would have swept the raging waters. Blessed be the Lord, who did not give us prey to their teeth. Our life like a bird has escaped from the snare of the fowler. Indeed, the snare has been broken, and we have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
God has chosen us to be his adopted children through his Son. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. He chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him. He destined us in love to be his sons through Jesus Christ, according to the purpose of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace, which he freely bestowed on us in the Beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace, which he lavished upon us. He has made known to us in all wisdom and insight the mystery of his will, according to his purpose, which he set forth in Christ. His purpose he set forth in Christ as a plan for the fullness of time, to unite all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. God has chosen us to be his adopted children through his Son.
Brothers, do not slander one another. Anyone who slanders a brother or condemns him is speaking against the law and condemning the law. But if you condemn the law, you have stopped keeping it and become a judge over it. There is only one lawgiver, and he is the only judge, and has the power to acquit or to sentence. Who are you to give verdict on your neighbour? Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. I said, Lord, have mercy on me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you.
My soul magnifies the Lord, since God has had regard for my humble state. My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. He looks on his servant in her loneliness. Henceforth, all angels will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels for me. Holy his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength and scatters the proud-hearted. He casts them off. He fills the starving with good things, sends the rich away empty. He protects Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our fathers, to Abraham and his sons forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. My soul magnifies the Lord, since God has had regard for my great estate.
The will of Christ is for all men to be saved. Let us pray that his will may be done. Draw all men to yourself. Lord, by your sacrifice on the cross, you redeemed us from the slavery of sin. Lead us to the freedom and glory of the sons of God. Draw all men to yourself, Lord. Be with our Bishop Mark and all the bishops of your church. Grant them courage and compassion in their ministry. Draw all men to yourself, Lord. Help those who seek the truth to find it. Let them be consecrated in truth. Draw all men to yourself, Lord. We pray especially for peace in family life, for those orphaned and widowed. Comfort them in your love. Draw all men to yourself, Lord. May our departed brothers and sisters come to the heavenly city. There with the Father and the Holy Spirit, you will reign forever. Draw all men to yourself. Anybody's got any intercessions they want to add?
I'd like to pray for John Cox, recovering from a procedure. He should be blessed with God's grace and the healing power of our Lord Jesus.
Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Lord God, it is our bounden duty to proclaim you as the light, with whom there is no alteration or shadow of change. Enlighten our darkness as we reach the close of this day, and in your mercy forgive us our sins. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us praise the Lord. Gotta go. Ta-ra. See you in a minute. In a bit.
Bev, if you want to sit further in, because then you're a full 2 metres from someone coming down the middle.
Thank you. evening, everyone.
You're going to be freezing sat there, Bev, with the wind blowing through. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Right, if I can just explain to those who have become back to Mass for the first time, wonderful to be here, really very welcome. For the reception of Holy Communion, the safest way to do this is that we stand side on, okay? That means there's the maximum distance between me and you, keeps you safe, keeps me safe. Just before my Holy Communion, I will raise the host, behold the Lamb of God, but then I will also say the body of Christ, and you respond, Amen. Then the chalice, the blood of Christ, you respond, Amen. Obviously, very sadly, you're not able to receive under both kinds at the moment. I receive Holy Communion, then come down, and if you stand by this yellow and black marker you'll see on the carpet, which is really, really obvious, I'll stand side on to you, you stand side on to me, you extend the hand that you normally receive in, and I will say nothing, because you've already exchanged the body of Christ, Amen. Your hand as flat as possible, then there's the least chance of any contact between us. Receive, stand to one side, remove your mask, receive our Lord as the bread and wine of life. Okay? Yeah, do nod. Excellent. Right, let's stand to begin our celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
Mask.
I don't have one with me, sorry.
Can we have a spare mask, please? For your penance. It's only when you come to the end of the first reading you realise what is being said. If you pay too much attention to the name of a town at the beginning, you will get the wrong point. So wait until the very last verse, and then you realise, oh, okay. Jesus obviously is inspired by the prophets. The way of the kingdom is clearly proclaimed in the prophets. So let us turn and ask for forgiveness, so that we may hear within our spirit the God who speaks. You have set us free from slavery to corruption and sin. Lord, have mercy. You are the divine sower, sowing seeds of eternal life. Christ, have mercy. Your word will not return void, but will accomplish God's will. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. In unity, we gather with those who are joining us through streaming or catching up on YouTube. It's been quite incredible, the power of the Spirit that we have felt during this time, spiritually close. So let's unite ourselves here and through the online. Let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who, for the faith they profess, are accounted Christians, the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honour. Through our Lord, Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
My technological fault.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Hear the word of the Lord.
Let us stand to greet the gospel.
Lord, all of the earth you worship for your love.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus instructed the 12 as follows. Do not suppose that I have come to bring peace to the earth. It is not peace I have come to bring, but a sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. A man's enemies will be those of his own household. Anyone who prefers father or mother to me is not worthy of me. Anyone who prefers son or daughter to me is not worthy of me. Anyone who does not take his cross and follow in my footsteps is not worthy of me. Anyone who finds his life will lose it. Anyone who loses his life for my sake will find it. Anyone who welcomes you welcomes me, and those who welcome me welcome the one who sent me. Anyone who welcomes a prophet because he is a prophet will have a prophet's reward. And anyone who welcomes a holy man because he is a holy man will have a holy man's reward. If anyone gives so much as a cup of cold water to one of these little ones because he is a disciple, and I tell you solemnly, he will most certainly not lose his reward. When Jesus had finished instructing his 12 disciples, he moved on from there to teach and preach in their towns. The Gospel of the Lord. So please, if you haven't read the prophet Isaiah, as we're going to be listening to a whole series of readings from him, or really from them, it'd be great for you to begin reading through Isaiah. But it was written across three different styles of writing, covering many, many years, but attributed to the one Isaiah. And sadly, far too many Catholics, as soon as they hear, oh, Sodom and Gomorrah, I know what this is about. No, you don't. It's been misrepresented and misinterpreted for decades. Take your wrongdoing out of my sight. Cease evil, do good, search for justice. Help the oppressed, be just to the orphan and the widow, the absolute marginalized people of their society. The orphan, the widow, often would be left to die. They have no one. It's not my responsibility, don't belong to my family. Go to the wilderness and die. And there is the Lord calling for justice and care for these people. We listened to this section of Matthew, I think, 3 Sundays ago. It's the end of a whole series of chapters where Jesus is teaching the 12 to send them out on mission. So this evening, that's you and me being sent out on mission. And Jesus is not pulling his punches. We looked at this at one of the Annual Formation Zoom meetings. Whoever knew I was going to be using that word ever in my life, but there you go. And one of the participants said, Jesus tells it like it is, so Father Peter, you've got to tell it like it is. Because not everyone really wants to hear the strength of the teaching of Jesus. Prefer family to me? You're not worthy of me. Boy, that's tough. That's really tough. If you don't want to lose your life, forget it, you'll never find your life. If you don't take up your cross, don't bother. Really? Can I try a bit? Let me have a go. No, Jesus is so demanding. Totally respond to me. If you You're not ready to do that, you're not ready. Wow. Okay? So we really have to let the words be an enormous challenge to all of us. I assure you, whenever I read these, I gulp. How much have I progressed? We have to work with the Spirit, or the other way around, the Spirit works with us, and we choose to say yes to the Spirit. And then we can continue more and more to be missionary disciples, which is the phrase that Pope Francis keeps on using of us, because the huge need is there. So let's be still. Let's allow ourselves to be aware of the call of action for the poor, the oppressed. God knows, in town today, across our own country, there are so many in these terrible, terrible needs. And the call to commit ourselves to Jesus. Remain seated. So let's pray that we will be able to hear and respond to the God who speaks, even though it is a very, very challenging word. Lord, hear us. We pray for the poor, the needy in town, families who have been locked together for so long, not all of them managing that well. So we pray for peace and reconciliation. Lord, hear us. I think I'm right, it's the last week for all of our schools, not from parents, yeah? Okay. Pray for our schools, pray for the parents who've only just got rid of their darlings for a while, and now they're back home for another 6 weeks. Peace and reconciliation. Lord, hear us. And we've been asked to pray for Jeanette, who has had to go into hospital, and it's even more difficult because she is the carer for her husband, Roger. Pray for, excuse me, Mary Riley, who is now home after a major operation. Excuse me. For Joan Cox, who is also home. For Anne Farrell, who continues her treatment. And for Mark, who continues his. Just hay fever, honestly. We offer our own prayers, very aware of those who are joining us through streaming or will catch up on YouTube. United in the Spirit, we pray for each other. Lord, hear us. Lord God, yours is a kingdom of peace and endless joy. Your Son sows seeds of faith into our hearts and gives us the Holy Spirit to make them grow. May our faith work your wonders in our world. Help us to wait in eager expectation for the coming of your kingdom. Through Christ our Lord. So as I offer the gifts from the altar of sacrifice, please, normally it's the presentation of the gifts, we can't do that. The offering of yourselves. You're calling me to be a missionary, to be worthy of your call. Lord, help me to, and us to continue to change. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look upon the offerings of the Church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that, when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in his holiness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself, and by the blood of his cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore, he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for "For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When communion is prepared and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Mark, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Amen. We know so profoundly the needing of healing within our world, not just with the pandemic, but so many other situations. We pray fully for the kingdom. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. It's our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." Amen. Word of warning for the communion song. Those of you here, You will be so tempted to join in. Please do not. You watching us through the streaming, you can sing your hearts out. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. The body of Christ. Blood of Christ.
I am.
brothers and sisters celebrating with us through the streaming or YouTube, let's join in a moment of silent prayer and wonder at the gift of the Word and the gift of the Eucharist. Consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effect upon us may grow. Through Christ our Lord. Thanks very especially to the stewards who make this possible. We are going to need a few more stewards, so please, if it's possible, younger than 70, no underlying health issues, so please, those of us joining us through streaming and YouTube also. Those who, for it was your first Mass, was it okay? Strange, but okay? Good, good. Do pass on to others when you speak to them on the phone, when you text them, when you see them at the shops, social distancing, say, it's okay. But they do have to book. Weekdays obviously are okay, but weekends, on Sunday, one person had to be told, I'm very sorry, but there's no room left. We are increasing the numbers to make it a little bit easier in both of our church buildings. So that will be done. It's been done today in spirit. I'll see what it's like tomorrow, and then it will be done here during the week as well. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
I'm tired.